A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After 3 months, we set sail on a ship that had wintered at the island of Malta. It was an Alexandrian ship with the Dioscuri as its figurehead. We put in at Syracuse and stayed there 3 days, and from there we sailed round the coast and arrived at Regium. After a day, a south wind came up, and in 2 days, we reached Puteoli. There we found some brothers and were urged to stay with them for 7 days, and thus we came to Rome. The brothers from there heard about us and came as far as the Forum of Appius and 3 taverns to meet us. On seeing them, Paul gave thanks to God and took courage. When he entered Rome, Paul was allowed to live by himself with the soldier who was guarding him. He remained for 2 full years in his lodgings. He received all who came to him, and with complete assurance and without hindrance, he proclaimed the kingdom of God and taught about the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Sing praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. After the crowd had eaten their fill from the loaves, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and precede him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the 4th watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they cried, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, "O ye of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. A couple of quick footnotes. One, geographic and the other personal. If you read this description from the Acts of the Apostles, most of those towns are still there. Okay? We know all about Malta. Syracuse is still there in Sicily. You can go and visit it. And from Syracuse, they go to Regium. That's Reggio Calabria, at the tip of the boot. It's still there now. After they go to Puteoli. That's just outside Naples. It's called Pozzuoli now. Just slight different pronunciation. The Tre Taberni, the three taverns outside Rome. You know, the place doesn't change. They call it the Eternal City. They might as well call it the Eternal Country. You know, it's really beautiful. Now, the personal confession, this past visit was probably the first, I think it was absolutely the first time in my life I've ever been in Rome for any period of time whatsoever, and actually not made it into St. Peter's. Just the way it worked this time. Just the way it worked this time. But nevertheless, we celebrate the dedication of the basilicas of Saints Peter and Paul, and those that at least have been with me in groups to Rome, and others, other groups into Rome, I'm sure have been to both of those basilicas. See how splendid they are now and whatnot. But we don't really celebrate the basilicas themselves as buildings today. We do celebrate the memory of those people, Peter and Paul, for whom those monuments were built. And we don't even celebrate them so much as we celebrate the faith that was contained in them, the faith in Jesus Christ that they brought to the world. Now, it strikes me in comparing Peter and Paul, one way of looking at them would be by the phrase roots and wings. Peter especially, if you remember the words that were described in the second chapter of the letter to the Galatians, where Paul is talking about the arrangement that he had, the working arrangement with Peter, Cephas as he calls him, and James and John, about how they were going to give each other the right hand of fellowship, and that Cephas would be going to the circumcised, and he and Barnabas would be committed to going to the uncircumcised. Very, very nice. And so it suggests to me that the primary dimension of Peter, therefore, is roots. He wanted to understand and to bring the good news of Jesus Christ to his people, to the Jewish people. Paul, on the other hand, represents wings a little bit more. He was much more open to going to all the Gentiles, all over the world. Both of them winding up in Rome, and both of them sharing roots and wings, because, of course, Paul started as a Jewish Pharisee. And Peter, at the end, was very open to mixed congregations, Jew and Gentile alike. We saw that in Antioch. We could see that in other places as well. And so the balance of roots and wings is terribly important. We want to stay ourselves rooted in our origins and in our faith and the truth of the church. We also have to have the wings that allow us to go where the Holy Spirit sends us. And so Peter and Paul represent those two dimensions of the faith, I think, that are so important for us. And we can ask the Lord then to strengthen us both in our rootedness and in our ability to soar with the grace of the Holy Spirit. Let us stand and pray.